Brothers and sisters, this is your favorite brother from another mother. Hallelujah. Lord has given me an exciting word for you, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. I've been here worshiping the Lord and praising the Lord, and the Lord had given me, there's a word for a specific sister, and part of that word, the Lord said, I want you to give this word to all my people. This part of this word, so that's part of the word I'm getting ready to give you. Anyway, brothers and sisters, let me just say this. I'll get right into it. In the book of Revelation, chapter 4, verse 1, that's used by theologians as one of the verses that talks about the rapture, as John representing the church is on earth during Revelation 1, 2, and 3. And then starting with verse 4, there's no more mention of the church. And then it goes into the tribulation. And there's a, it says there's a, John looked and there was a door open in heaven. And a voice saying, come up here. Now, the Lord also speaks to the two witnesses in Revelation chapter 11 and tells them, come up here. And so, of course, when the Lord descends from heaven with a shout for the rapture, he will also say to us, I believe he'll call us each by name and say, come up here. So that's from 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 16, 17, 18. For it says, for the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout. And I believe that shout will be your name, come up here. My name, come up here. With the voice of the archangel and the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first, and those of us who are alive and remain shall be caught up together to meet them in the air. Now, another verse we use for that, that not all Christians will be raptured, but those who have patiently kept the word of God, the church of Philadelphia, Revelation chapter 3, verse 10. Jesus says, because you have kept the word of my patience, or patiently kept my word in modern English, I will keep you out of the hour of temptation to come upon the whole earth. And there's other verses like Luke 21, 36. The Lord said, watch and pray always that you be kind of worthy to escape these things. What things? The tribulation he's just talking about. And stand before the Son of Man. And you know what? The Lord showed me something I've never noticed before. I've never noticed this before for some reason. Maybe many of you have not. I don't know. I don't know if I've heard people teaching it or not. But check this out. This is to the Church of Philadelphia, which is the group of Christians who will be raptured, the faithful bride, the wise virgins. Let's see. Okay, Revelation 3, verse 7. And to the angel of, this is the Lord Jesus Christ speaking through to the Apostle John. And to the angel of the church in Philadelphia write these things, saith him, he that is holy, he that is true, he that hath the key of David, he that openeth, and no man shutteth, and shutteth, and no man openeth. It's one of my favorite things about the Lord. He opens doors that no man can shut, and shuts doors that no man can open. Okay, he's talking to the church that'll be raptured. I know thy works. Behold, I've set before thee an open door. And that's the word the Lord wanted me to give you. He has set before you an open door, and me an open door. And when the Lord told me that, I'm thinking also, of course, about to do God's will. You know, the Lord is opening the door for us to serve him and not be hindered by the enemy. But the Lord said, go look this up. And now I see that it connects, of course, not only to the Lord letting us do his will, but to the rapture. Never thought about it. Revelation 4, verse 1, there's that open door, and John is called to come up here, signifying that the door is open for the rapture. And here it is. With the church that'll be raptured, it talks about the open door. And Jesus says in verse 7, you know, he says, he said, he has the key of David. And he says, I open and no man shutteth, and I shutteth and no man open. Nobody can stop you from being raptured. If you are called by God and you're walking with the Lord and you're one of the wise virgins and you've got your oil and you're rapture ready, nobody can stop you. Praise God. And no man can shut it. And the Lord is the one who opened it. Hallelujah. We have an open door. Hallelujah. Praise God. No man shutteth. And no man, and I shut doors that no man can open. Verse 8, I know thy works. Behold, I have set before thee an open door. Listen, we're not saved by good works. The Bible says, and people love to quote this, the hypergracers, Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8 and 9. For by grace are you saved through faith, not of your own, but a gift of God. Not by works, lest any man should boast. You're saved, not by works. But the next verse, verse 9, verse 10, it says, but you're saved unto do good works, brothers and sisters. So when Jesus is talking to the churches, he's talking about two Christians. What have you done as a Christian, brothers and sisters? Not to become a Christian. But what have you done as a Christian? And what does Jesus say? Verse 8, I know thy works. He didn't say, oh, I know your faith. Well, of course you had to be faith, have faith to be saved. He said, I know your works as a Christian, right? Behold, I have set before thee an open door, and no man can shut it. For thou hast a little strength, and hast kept my word, and hast not denied my name Behold, I make them of the synagogue of Satan, which say they are Jews and are not, sacred namers, and the like. But do lie. Behold, I will make them to come and worship before thy feet to know that I have loved thee. Because thou hast kept the word of my patience, or patiently kept my word in modern English, I will keep thee from the hour of temptation which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth. Behold, I come quickly. Hold that fast which thou hast, that no man take thy crown. He that overcometh, I will make a pillar in the temple of my God, and he shall go no more out, and I will write upon him the name of my God and the name of the city of my God, which is New Jerusalem, which is coming down from heaven from my God, and I'll write upon him my new name. He that have an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says unto the churches. Now the next church is the last church, the Laodicean church, that's the end times church, the lukewarm church, which is what we're surrounded by, brothers and sisters, those foolish virgins. We are surrounded by the lukewarm Laodicean end time church, brothers and sisters. And I made tons of videos to them, calling them to repentance. But this, brothers and sisters, is a word of edification for you, those of you whom the Lord has set open door in front of us. There is nothing more greater than the fact that the Lord has opened a door that no man can shut. Hallelujah. Because he knows our works. He knows our, you know, that we have tried to patiently keep his word, hallelujah, praise God, even though we have a little strength, praise God, it only takes a mustard seed of faith, hallelujah, you know, to be healed, to be delivered, to be set free, to be born again, a mustard seed of faith, hallelujah. Oh, what small faith we must offer unto the Lord, and the Lord does the rest, brothers and sisters, hallelujah. We just said yes to him, and he's doing the rest. We said yes, and he does the rest, hallelujah, praise God, hallelujah. In my last video, the Lord had it in my spirit to say our God is awesome, that our God is awesome, hallelujah. And now I'm just wanting to worship the Lord at how magnificent he is, how awesome he is, how great he is, how wonderful he is, hallelujah, how amazing he is, hallelujah. You are amazing, God, hallelujah. By Chris Tomlin sings that song, hallelujah. Indescribable, uncontainable, you place the stars in the sky and you know them by name. You are amazing, God. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. He's all powerful, unchangeable. Yes, Lord. You set the stars in the sky and you know them by name. Yes, Lord. You are amazing, God. Hallelujah. God is amazing, brothers and sisters. So, brothers and sisters, now that you know you have an open door before you, and of course the children among us, the babies among us, love to grab onto that which is true about the rapture. But brothers and sisters, the Lord's got an open door for us right now. For those of you who are a little bit more mature in the Lord, a little more grown up in the Lord, hallelujah. There's an open door, brothers and sisters, where we can go in and out of the presence of the Lord. We can go into the garden with God. When Jesus died on the cross, it says that the veil was ripped from top to bottom. You know, the veil is like, I forget now. I used to know the conversion of it. It's like 14 feet higher, whatever. No one could reach up there and grab it. And plus, it's like, I forgot, it's 4 or 5, 6 inches thick, whatever. You couldn't just sit there and rip that veil. And it wasn't ripped from the bottom, but from the top. You know, that God is the one who did it. Hallelujah. And there was an earthquake too. And it signified that the way was open. Hallelujah. The ark was already gone by then. Jeremiah already hid the ark back there at the time of when Nebuchadnezzar sacked Jerusalem. You know, the ark, of course, will be returned and they will have it there during the tribulation. Hallelujah. Praise God. They probably already have it now, as it's many people speculate that they already got it. But it doesn't matter, brothers and sisters. People love to make a hobby out of that, you know, about the ark. We've got the ark. We've got the Lord Jesus Christ. Don't be caught up with those of the synagogue of Satan. That ark is a type and a shadow. Hallelujah. I'd rather have Jesus. Hallelujah. I'd rather have Jesus than silver and gold. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I can't think of the other words of the song. Hallelujah. But it's about Jesus. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, I would rather have Jesus than silver than riches untold. Hallelujah. It's all about Jesus. He's more valuable. The hem of his garment is more valuable than 10,000 arks of the covenant. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Those are just a shadow and a pattern what Moses saw on the mountain. God told Moses, you know, make the tabernacle and the ark and all that after the pattern that I showed you in heaven. Hallelujah. That's a shadow. Hallelujah. It's just like someone having a model train set. You know, and then you go there, and then there's a real train that crosses the whole United States from Los Angeles to New York, a high-speed bullet train. Let's just say they ever built one. You know, if we ever had a good government and they facilitated the building of a great, fast railroad, a bullet train across the United States, and then you got a model train saying, oh, come look at my model train. This is the greatest thing in the world. This model train is better than that high-speed rail. You know, as a matter of fact, come try to ride my little model train around in my basement, you know, as opposed to getting on this train riding, you know, from New York to L.A. and whatever, some bullet train. I mean, come on, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. You know, get your eyes on the one who created the pattern for the ark, the one who gave into the imagination of Moses and those artisans that the Lord called. God raised up artisans of the children of Israel to build the ark. He put his spirit in their heart to make those things, the Bible says. Hallelujah. He put his spirit in the heart of Noah and his sons to build his ark, the ark for the flood. He put his spirit in the heart of those lions and tigers and bears to go get on the ark. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So we don't worship Noah's ark. We don't worship the ark of the covenant. But hallelujah, out of the one infinite tiny little drop of the mind of our amazing God was given to make those things into the hearts of men and beasts, according to those animals that went to the ark and submitted to humans and not as a wild animal. Hallelujah. Praise God. You are amazing, God. Yes. Yes, he is indescribable, uncontainable. He set the stars in the sky and he knows them by name. You are amazing, God. Hallelujah, Lord God. Yes, Lord. You are all powerful, unchangeable. Yes, Lord. Yes. Lord, we praise you right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. We thank you, Lord God. We praise you, Father, for you have created us, Lord God, to worship you. Yes, Lord. You created us to worship. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. You created us to praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes. Yes, Lord. We bless your holy name, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. We bow down. We lay our crowns at the feet of Jesus and we cry, holy, holy, holy. And we cry, holy, holy, holy is the Lamb. Yes, Lord God, you are worthy. Worthy is the Lamb that was slain. Worthy is the Lamb that was slain. Yes, Lord. You are righteous and holy, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes. And we bless your holy name. Hallelujah, Lord God. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We thank you, Lord God, that we are no longer ashamed in your presence. Yes, we are no longer ashamed. Lord, you took our blame and you took our shame and you buried it under the cross. Lord, you paid the cost for me. You, Lord, you took the pain for me. You, Lord, your blood has changed me. You, Lord, you went before me. You, Lord, Lord, you adore me. You, Lord. You took my shame. Lord, we thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. We bless your name, Lord God. Hallelujah, creator of heaven and earth, Lord. Yes, Lord. You are the mighty God. Hallelujah, Lord. You are the awesome God. Yes, Lord. You are the great I am. age to age, still the same awesome God. You are the awesome God. You are the great I am. Age to age, still the same awesome God. Hallelujah, Lord God. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We bow down, Lord. And we lay our crowns at your feet, Lord Jesus. Yes, Lord. And we cry, holy, holy, holy. We cry, holy, holy, holy is the Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Yes, Lord. You are great. You are mighty. So we cry, Lord, you're worthy of all praise. Be exalted, our God. Yes, Lord. You are worthy and worthy and greatly to be praised. Yes, holy is the Lamb of God. Yes, Lord. Yes, you are holy, Lord. Yes, Lord. We declare your righteousness. Hallelujah, in this place. You are awesome in this place, mighty God. You're awesome in this place, my Redeemer. You are awesome in this place, mighty God. You are awesome in this place, my Redeemer. You are awesome in this place, mighty God. Yes, Lord. You are awesome in this place, my Redeemer. Brothers and sisters, the Lord has opened the door for you to enter into his presence. Yes, Lord. And the Lord is calling you. He's drawing your spirit today. Hey, yes, you've been trying to go higher by yourself, but you can't do it. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. There's many people trying. That's the thing that the number one message I've been trying to get across to Christians. Now, number one message is the gospel, and then to be rapture ready. But for those who are trying to grow in the Lord, hallelujah, the number one message I can give you is you've been trying to go higher by yourself, but you can't do it. It's not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord. The word of God says that, you know, because of what Jesus has done, you know, therefore we can come boldly before the throne of grace to obtain mercy. You got to come boldly. You know that song I sang about it? I sang, he took my shame. That was a song the Lord just gave me right now while I was making this video. That's not a song that's been written down as far as I know. And that's the message. You know, we can come boldly before the throne of grace to obtain mercy. It says, Moses said, Lord, if I found favor with you, hallelujah, show me your glory. Hallelujah. And the Lord is saying there's an open door. Hallelujah. This is for those who want more of you and less of me. Lord, give me more of you and less of me. You know, cry, holy, holy, holy. We cry, holy, holy, holy is the Lord. You know, the Lord responds. We provoke the Lord. You know, it's just like a parent. You know, you go to the school play and your kid is in the play. You know, when your kid starts singing, they can be a good singer, bad singer, whatever. That's your kid. You're going to be there videotaping your kid. Hallelujah. Now, our Father, who art in heaven, when he's there on his throne, and all that stuff that's going on in heaven, you know, all the angels flying around, the cherubim and seraphim, they're bowing down before him. Hallelujah. You know, praise God for all the things going on in heaven. But, brothers and sisters, when we, his children, as he says in his word, the Spirit of the Lord inhabits the praises of his people, when we begin to worship him, when you, as a Christian, we as children of God begin to worship him. The Lord is like, just like any father. He's our Father. You know, he's listening. He's listening, brothers and sisters. He's proud of his children. We're worshiping and praising him and doing good things and doing the right thing. The Lord is proud of us just like any of us are proud of our children. You know, you say that you're a Christian. You say that God is your Father. Well, act like it. Why are you acting like, you know, that's religious people. That's trying to go higher by yourself. You know, the Lord's giving me the definition. It's people that stand off from a distance, you know, just like Adam and Eve when they tried to cover their own selves with a fig leaf, you know, trying to be all pomp and, well, thou us doest and, you know, and all this stuff, you know. and trying to be standoffish from God. You know, like the children of Israel, they were afraid of God. They said, Moses, you go up there for us. You know, as a preacher, and I know that all preachers probably deal with this, people are like, well, you know, go to the Lord for me. You know, well, the Bible says there's one mediator between man and God. That's the man, the Lord Jesus Christ. But the thing about it is, brothers and sisters, it's true that the job of a pastor is to help people, to help facilitate and connect them to the one mediator, the Lord Jesus Christ. That's it. And when you get off the path for us to call from the sidelines, hey, you know, you're getting off the path. You know, you're going the wrong way. You got some wrong doctrine here or whatever. And you need to get back in there and start following the Lord Jesus Christ. You're getting off track. That's the job of minister, of people in the ministry, to help you along the way. Hallelujah. To assist you along the way. You know, it's like in the army. I used to be in the army and I was in Iraq in the war. And, you know, I was a medic. So it's kind of like that. You know, you're there to help people and assist people. But the commander is the one leading the battle. You know, you're supposed to be following the commander in the war. But people like the medic, or even like in the army, if you know about the military, the first sergeant, you know, it's there to help make sure that the soldiers have food, to make sure the soldiers get their mail, to make sure the soldiers sleep and eat and brush their teeth. And if they have to take like a, you know, they forced us to take pills for malaria, you know, make sure everybody takes their malaria pill every week or whatever. Those kind of things. That's what preachers do. But in a war, you know, in the military, the commander is the one leading the way. And that's what a lot of times people are following preachers who are trying to be the commander. And a lot of times people are trying to go themselves. They're trying to, oh, I'm just going to go over here and go over here and win this battle. You can't go win any battle by yourself. You've got to go when the commander says, let's go. You know, it's a team effort. You know, you have your part to play. You know, you may be the machine gunner, but there's a dude that's carrying the ammo. You know, you can carry the machine gun there, but if you don't have somebody giving you the ammo, well, you're going to be running out pretty quick. You know, if you don't have air support from those prayer warriors, I can go to a hole. The Lord's giving me, dropping this wisdom on me right now. I can go on and on as the Lord is just dumping it on me. You know, you got to have those intercessors and prayer warriors, like when I went to the Philippines. You know, those Filipino churches that I started, not a single one of the Filipinos that I ever started in the churches, like 100 families total, at least, not a single family ever contacted me and said, oh, Brother Patrick, how you doing? They had my email. They never contacted me. They only contacted me to complain about the Filipino pastors that took my place. But the mistake I made when I first went to the Philippines was not having prayer warriors. And, you know, thank the Lord led me to get on YouTube 2011. I didn't even think about it. I got on YouTube to make videos about the end times, as the Lord had led me. But the fruit of that that came back was I ran into brothers and sisters that are prayer warriors, that are the Air Force. Hallelujah for what the Lord would have me do. Praise God. I've been in battle from 2007. I actually started going to Philippines 2005, short term. From 2005 until 2011, I was operating in a war with no Air Force. Hallelujah. Except for what I prayed myself. You know, praise God that through YouTube, that Joshua's ministry in the Philippines, we got an Air Force. Some of you guys, the ones who are probably watching this video, praise God for you. Couldn't do it without you guys. The Lord wants us to have all those different parts. As the Bible says, you know, the hand can't say to the foot, you know, that I don't need you, you know, and all that. The different body parts, we're all different body parts of the body of Christ. And we all need each other. Praise God for that. That's where the commander comes in. He coordinates all those things by his spirit, brothers and sisters. He coordinates all those things that we can finish the race that God called us to do. So that's the corporate message there for the church and for the church of the firstborn, this group of us, Joshua's ministry, us who are talking on this YouTube channel, and for the body of Christ. My brothers and sisters, individually, the Lord has set an open door before you. Hallelujah. He's calling you and drawing you to come up here. The Lord is calling you to come sit with him. The Bible says we're already seated with Christ in heavenly places, far above powers and principalities and forces of darkness. We're already there. We're already seated with Christ. Hallelujah. Far above all gods, I worship you, Almighty God. There is none like you. Yes, Lord. I worship you, O Prince of Peace. That is what I long to do. And I give you praise, for you are my righteousness. And brothers and sisters, if the Spirit of the Lord is in you, the Spirit of the Lord, even as John the Baptist said, even as the Lord Jesus Christ said, you know, if these children won't worship me, you know, the rocks will cry out. John the Baptist said the Lord could raise up children out of the rocks. Hallelujah. You know, the Spirit of the Lord is in me, compelling me to praise His name, compelling me to talk about how great is our God. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? How great is our God? Hallelujah. Name above all names, You are worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How great is our God. Hallelujah. Yes. Yes, Lord. We bless You, Father, in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Time is in His hands. Yes. The beginning and the end. Beginning and the end. Yes, Lord. I haven't heard that song in a long time. He wraps Himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at His voice, and trembles at His voice. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God. Yes, Lord. We bless You, Lord God. Yes, Lord, You are the mighty God. You are the awesome God. Yes, Lord, we bless You right now. Father, we thank You. We bow before You and we worship You, Lord. We thank You for Your grace, for Your mercy, for Your loving kindness toward us, Lord. Your steadfast love. Hallelujah. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is Thy faithfulness, O Lord. Great is Thy faithfulness. Hallelujah, Lord God, we bless You. Brothers and sisters, it's just that simple. We begin to walk on the water and praising Him, and the Lord responds. He anoints us. He lifts us up. Hallelujah. He said, call upon Me and I will answer you and show you great mighty things that you know not. Jeremiah 33:3, the phone number of God. Hallelujah. Bless His name. He said, draw close to Me and I'll draw close to you. Hallelujah. Let's bless His name. Brothers and sisters, I ask you to enter in. The door is open. Let's enter in. Hallelujah. Draw me, Lord, and I'll come running after You. Hallelujah. Pray to Him and call upon His name. Draw me, Lord, and I'll come running after You. Hallelujah. I asked You to draw me, Lord, and I'll come running after You. Hallelujah, Lord. We bless You, Lord. We worship You, Lord. Yes, Lord. We praise You, Lord, and we worship You. Yes, Lord. Yes. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Lord, whatever You do, yes, Lord. Come and do it in me, Lord. The glory of God, it thrills my life, and I will never be the same again. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. I will never be the same again. I'll never return. I've closed the door. I'll walk the path, I'll run the race, and I will never be the same again. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Fall like fire, soak like rain. Yes. Flood of mighty waters again and again. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, come burn away the chaff, Lord. Yes, Lord, we bless you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord, we bless you right now, Lord. I will never be the same again. Yes, Lord. We bless you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I pray that you'll never be the same again. One moment in his presence, hallelujah, will change you forever, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. In the manifested presence of God. Hallelujah. I'm trying to help get you there. That's what the Lord wants me to do. Help you get you there. Get rapture ready. Hallelujah. The door is open. Enter in. You can enter into his presence. Hallelujah. For in his presence, we shall prevail. Hallelujah. We prevail in his presence, brothers and sisters. He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High God shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my shield and my strength. Hallelujah. Bless his name. Hallelujah. In him shall I trust. Psalm 91. Blessed be his name. Hallelujah.